Adin Kabir Mohanty from Bath High School, Gurgaon. I'm by PO5, and I'll be speaking to Ms. Charu Jain from an NGO called the Adit Foundation about plastic waste in Gurgaon and its impact on the future and the environment.
I'm Charu from Adit Foundation. We work on environment conservation and livelihood enhancement. I'm very happy that Adyan from Pathways is curious to know about plastics and environment, how it could make an impact on the environment, how it could make an impact on our lives, and what can we do about it.
Do you think plastics are hazardous to the environment?
Not really hazardous. Plastics can actually be recycled 100%. So it's not hazardous for the environment, but what is bad is one-time use plastic, over packaging, because that's where we are creating more waste. And because we need to curtail the amount of waste, which is an environment hazard, is where we need to cut down on our consumerism.
Then are there any alternatives to plastics in the packaging industry?
Yes, alternatives are glass, tin, but it's hard to replace a plastic bottle with a glass bottle because the amount of energy used is very high. It's heavy, it has a higher volume, so the amount of space is required is high, but they are alternatives to packaging. Whether good or bad is something which is debatable. Yeah. We get up in the morning, our morning starts with a plastic. Our foam mattresses are plastic. Our toothpaste packaging is plastic. We really can't replace it to glass. Imagine a supermarket full of packaged materials, everything in glass. The amount of volume is so high. The cost of transportation increases because the volume is higher, the weight is higher. So the fuel consumption becomes higher in transportation.
Then what do you think about microplastics? How are they made?
See, microplastics are nothing but very small size broken plastic. Problem is not microplastic. We know of microplastic presence in cosmetics. Now everybody is talking about presence of plastics in salt. But how did this plastic reach the sea? It's because it was not disposed at the right place. So it's we who are responsible for the plastic presence in the seawater, because of which it is getting broken down into smaller pieces and going into salt.
And then polymers, what kind of compounds do they have? Kind of chemical compounds they have that make?
Toxic is if you eat them, they are toxic. They are not meant to be eaten. Glass is not meant to be eaten. Tin is not meant to be eaten. So it is a toxic. Yeah. But the technology is such that it cannot decompose naturally. So there is a problem with the polymer or the plastic industry. So it makes it hazardous to the environment because it cannot decompose naturally.
So, can plastics be decomposed or destroyed?
They can be 100% recycled. So, it's the way how we look at it. It is bad for the environment because they do not get decomposed. But at the same time, they are good for the environment because they are recycled. They are 100% recycled. So, the perspective can vary.
So, are there any sort of tests or anything?
But there are tests which can test the presence of microplastics in food or cosmetics or anywhere else.
And what do you think about the future of the plastic industry in India?
See, unless plastic is to do with waste management. Plastic per se technology has no problem. But because there is excessive waste creation because of plastic, so unless waste becomes an election manifesto, the future is bleak. We talk about Swachh Bharat Mission. We've been talking about it, but we don't really see much on ground. We know about the happiness index of Bhutan. Similarly, probably India, unless we have a cleanliness index and we start choosing our government or a representative of our government based on a cleanliness index, our future looks bleak. The present day problems per se, what we talk about, whether it's air, whether it's food, whether it's technology like plastic, what we are talking about, water, is all because of, I think, our waste management is not in place. The air is bad because it's not just vehicular pollution, it's also dust on the road, so much dust. The stubble burning happening at the farmers. It's very easy to say that the farmer is at fault. But there are also studies which say that the Monsanto maize growing has had a very big hand in changing the state policy, because of which the farmers are growing, planting maize in October, in June, and not in April. And that is because this stubble burning has started happening in October, while earlier it happened sometime in April.
ਸਰਕਾਰਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਨੀਤੀਆਂ ਬਣਾਈਆਂ ਹੋਈਆਂ ਨੇ, ਸਰਕਾਰਾਂ ਦੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਮਜਬੂਰ ਕੀਤੇ ਹਾਂ ਅੱਗ ਲਾਉਣ ਵਾਸਤੇ।
ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਪ੍ਰਦੂਸ਼ਣ ਦਾ ਧੂੰਆਂ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਉਹ ਕਿਸਾਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਚੜ੍ਹਦਾ ਹੈ, ਕਿਸਾਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਚੜ੍ਹਦਾ ਹੈ।
ਕਿਸਾਨ ਫਸਲ ਜਲਾ ਰਿਹਾ, ਕਿਤਨੇ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਕੋ ਪਕੜ ਕੇ ਫਾਈਨ ਕਰੋਗੇ, ਕਿਤਨੇ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਕੋ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋ ਸਕਦਾ। ਇਸਕਾ ਇਕਨੋਮਿਕ, ਇਟਸ ਐਨ ਇਕਨੋਮਿਕ ਪ੍ਰੋਬਲਮ।
ਹਾਈ ਕੋਰਟ ਨੇ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਨੂੰ ਕਈ ਮੌਕੇ ਦਿੱਤੇ ਆ, ਕਈ ਤਰੀਕਾਂ ਦਿੱਤੀਆਂ ਵੀ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਕਿਸਾਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਮਸ਼ੀਨਰੀ ਹੈ ਮੁਹੱਈਆ ਕਰਾਓ, ਉਹ ਤਾਂ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਨਾ ਕਾਮਯਾਬ ਹੋਈ ਹੈ। ਕਿਸਾਨਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਉਲਟ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਵੱਲੋਂ ਦਬਾਅ ਪਾਇਆ ਗਿਆ।
ਜਿਹੜਾ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਕਿਸਾਨ ਪ੍ਰਦੂਸ਼ਣ ਫੈਲਾ ਰਿਹਾ ਹੈ, ਅੰਕੜਿਆਂ ਮੁਤਾਬਕ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਕੱਢਿਆ ਜਾਵੇ ਤਾਂ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਖੇਤੀ ਦੇ ਮੁਤਾਬਕ ਪ੍ਰਦੂਸ਼ਣ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ ਧੂੰਏ ਦਾ, ਇਹ ਸਿਰਫ 6% ਪ੍ਰਦੂਸ਼ਣ ਹੈ ਸਾਲ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ। ਜਿਹੜਾ 55% ਪ੍ਰਦੂਸ਼ਣ ਫੈਕਟਰੀਆਂ ਦਾ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ, ਉਹਦੇ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਬਿਲਕੁਲ ਚੁੱਪ ਹੈ।
Since 1996, Monsanto and four other huge agrochemical businesses have quietly bought up almost every small seed manufacturer around the globe. And with their unprecedented control over the seed supply, they've fought to stop a natural process as old as time. Farmers saving seed from their current crop to be used in the next harvest, going to the extraordinary lengths of suing individual farmers for patent infringement. Take Indian farmers, for example. They aren't protected by government subsidies and have to take out loans just to afford seeds, and can have entire crops wiped out by unpredictable weather. But Monsanto prevents them from saving seeds as an insurance policy against the weather. The Indian government directly links the introduction and spread of GM cotton to a significant rise in the suicide rates of Indian farmers.
So there is a state policy which has gone haywire. There are waste coming out from the sea, not just industrial effluents, it's also sewage. It's all going into the land. Where are the sewage treatment plants? While at home we may do waste segregation, where are the waste management plants?
Eventually it just goes out.
The whole system is telling the people to do it. We are entitled for pure drinking water, whereas we all have to install filtration systems in our houses. It's a constitutional right for me to have clean air and clean water. We don't have it. So it's, one is, yes, we all have to be more aware, we have to be more conscious of our consumerism, so we create less waste, whether it's driving more car, whether it's buying chocolates and biscuits which are overpackaged, but at the same time our governance also has to set up systems for management. So it's a both-sided problem which we are facing. The dust on the streets remain. As an individual, as citizens, we can't do anything, but they have to be clean, the streets have to be clean, the roads have to be without potholes.
With the present scenario, how it is, we know we cannot change everything, but we can change what is within our control. We can't convince everybody to do what we want to do.
But there is hope for betterment.
There is hope for betterment. We just had Diwali this year. We just finished a couple of weeks. We all buy gifts for Diwali. We all buy sweets for Diwali. But if we shun buying these overpackaged sweets and gifts, is something which I can immediately do. If we shun as consumers and not buy their products because they are overpackaged,
they will be forced to stop manufacturing overpackaged. So while a corporate is also responsible for their products and packaging and the life cycle of the waste packaging, but as consumers, we can draw a line and say we will not buy this because it's overpackaged. That's within my control. I can segregate my waste in my house with this, which is in my control, and I can compost my kitchen waste, which is usually not more than 1 kg in a family of 6. Try and compost that, and the rest dry waste, still I believe that the company who's taking it, collecting it, recycles properly. But at my end, I can convert my waste to compost, I can segregate.
But there's only temporary solutions for now.
For now, you can't do much. You can do what is within your control. I can stop using one-time plastic. I can stop being over-consumerist. I can ensure my house and my place of stay has water harvesting. My house has composting. I can be water neutral. I can be waste neutral. But that's within my control. At least do my bit.
The ultimate goal of the new plastics economy is to design an economy where plastic packaging never becomes waste. And to do that, we need every single player in the chain to change the way that they do things.
Just having that option to say no makes it way easier for customers to reduce their trash.